Chief of Security.
This is an opportunity for us to really get into the schools and target issues that we might not have been able to target while schools were in operation.
And targeting concerns brought up following multiple school shootings reported across the nation just this past school year.
We talked a lot about, you know, the school shooting issues that we've seen in the states, having, you know, staff being dedicated to the front gates so that we're aware of anybody who comes on campus. So I know that we had a need to provide more sentry stations at the front gate. So we're going to be, you know, having you focus on providing that, and then going in and trying to resolve most of those common issues such as air conditioning and repairs. So as far as security goes, we're really relying on the principals, and you know, the principals and their 12-month staff will still be present on campus. Their job is to secure the campus, to ensure that it's safe over the summer.
A time for the department to prepare its facilities for the new school year, but also a time officials must keep close watch so that vandals and others don't take advantage of the classrooms not being used.
We always have to be vigilant. You know, again, working with our law enforcement officers, the KUAM Police Department, as well as our mayors, and anyone in the community. We have the neighborhood watch programs in certain areas. Make sure that we can keep extra eyes on the campuses, and just if you see something, just report it, and make sure that we're acting conservatively and cautiously to make sure we prevent bad things from happening to our schools.
Prevention so that the teachers and thousands of students next year can worry less about their safety and focus more on what's happening inside the classroom. Reporting for Guam's News Network, Guahusi Nick Delgado.
Giving those in need the dignity they deserve. The Salvation Army recently launched their Client Choice Food Program. Keani Mendiola has the story.
The name says it all. In celebration of their 26th year on Guam, the Salvation Army's new food program, Client Choice, gives clients the opportunity to shop for food items in the center's food pantry. A different experience than the organization's old model of bagging canned goods and passing them out. Salvation Army Corps Captain Tom Stambaugh.
In the pantry, we have racks of food that once they come through and do their paperwork, they're able to walk through with one of our volunteers or our staff to pick the items that work better for their families and take them home.
The pantry provides an array of canned foods and dried goods. Just kicking off on Thursday, the new program has already received a tremendous amount of positive feedback from its clientele.
As social services progresses, as we're learning more about the dignity of our clients, and essentially that's what we want to do, is have people feeling good about the options they're taking and feel good about coming and seeing us.
The new program also helps the organization to save money and food, preventing waste. Of course, there are limits based on family size, but clients are able to choose the items they prefer. Additionally, the Salvation Army is looking for more community involvement through donations, volunteers, or even ideas.
We're asking our community to help us because we're in need of some canned food items and fruit, peanut butter. Now with the summer months being out, shelf-stable milk, those kind of things that can help families really stretch their food budgets. We're asking for produce. So if we have farm-to-table folks that want to help donate eggplant or vegetables, so they have healthier options to take than just canned food all the time.
Food is distributed on Thursday and Friday mornings. For more information about the program or to donate, you can contact the Salvation Army at 477-9872 or visit their office in Tizen. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Keani Mendiola.
It's an effort to help those with a behavioral health illness, homeless, or at risk of being homeless. The Sagamami program recently opened the doors to their facility in Timuning, and the services offered to those who need it most. Here's more.
Support for those in need. The new Sagamami program had opened up its facility in Timuning to the community, showcasing its services for those with mental disability and others going through hard financial times. Gina Arca is a certified care specialist with the program that she says has been widespread across the nation for years.
Consumers of mental, receiving behavioral health services can go and socialize with each other, learn how to live in the community independently, but also be around other people who can understand how they are. So, you know, you can talk about your medications, you can talk about how you how your difficulties with people who understand you.
She says the program was actually created and founded by persons with mental illness.
It started up at the Behavioral Health Center, and now it's here with Guma Mommy as the contractors. Guma Mommy has had the contract like 4 times before. So they're pretty established in knowing how to run that. Eventually, the goal of this place is to be completely run by certified peer specialists. We also try to promote employment. We try to promote socialization, physical fitness, overall holistic health.
The program offers resources to help all interested be the best they can be in the community. Here's how it works. Once checking it out for a couple of days, ARCA says you will then need to get a referral to behavioral health for services needed before becoming a member.
Everyone has the ability to live out in the community. I mean, people with mental illness are not necessarily persons to be scared of, because we're human beings just like everybody else.
They are the most senior of our senior citizens. They belong to an exclusive club of just 7 members who have all lived for 100 years. Nestor Lakanto reports on Guam's centenarians.
Imagine it, to live for 100 years. Wishful thinking for most of us, but not for a handful of beloved Manamco who were showered with gifts and well wishes in the annual centenarian celebration hosted by the Department of Public Health to culminate Senior Citizens Month. Life is not short for these folks, all born before the roaring 20s. Imagine all the changes they've lived through, the technological advances that have transformed the world in ways they probably never could have imagined. We salute you, Shirley Marie Bridler, who turns 100 on August 20. Hats off to you, Julian Bryson Wilgus, 100 years old on June 22. Congratulations to Saria Cruz Arce, you're a century old. So is Paz Mendiola Sablon.
Thank you.
And Julie Blossablon, but only until July when she turns 101. Cheers to you, Hai Imu Shim, who is already 101. But they're all just kids to Josefina Dorotea Yamanaka Bloss, 103 years young this May. The secret to a long life?
Just think of something good. Just do good things to people. Well, that's all. I'm thankful to God for giving me, protecting me, and giving me this life.
Amen. For Guam's News Network, I'm Nestor Lakanto.
She's held the position for more than a decade, and now the woman who has acted as Guam's chief legal authority will be stepping down from office. Kiani Mendiola has this week's Decision Watch.
Attorney General Elizabeth Barrett Anderson has dedicated half of her life to serving the government of Guam and the justice system. Being the first Chamorro female attorney to practice law on Guam to sitting as a judge for the Superior Court of Guam, she has definitely made an impact on the island. Barrett Anderson has served as the AG for more than 10 years, her first term from 1987 to 1994, after she was appointed by Governor Joseph Atta, and subsequently in 2014, after she was elected for the position. But as her term comes to an end, Attorney General Barrett Anderson confirmed she has decided not to seek re-election.
I need to set my priorities this time. When I did it the first time, I had priorities, but I was able to continue on the job. I had the energy, I had the support, I had everything. This time, it's just come down to an absolute personal decision. I've given 38 years to the people of Guam. I've enjoyed every bit of public service.
She plans to spend more time with family, whom she attributes to all her success, and only wants to pass on the same love and support. But as her time in office comes to an end, she hopes to get as much work done with current cases.
There's 7 months left in my tenure, and I would be very happy if the federal district court judge closed the Ladzon case. I hope she will do that. Mm-hmm. So, but it's all at the discretion of the federal judge right now. The Davis case will be argued sometime in October. Hopefully the district court will render a decision before the end of the year, so I'll know what's happening with Davis. The Chamorro Land Trust case, unfortunately, will carry over past my tenure. The trial on that matter is scheduled for spring of next year.
Additionally, when speaking on some of the accomplishments throughout her time, such as the closing of the DOC consent decree, she commends the work of the entire agency and staff.
I'm very glad that I was able to have the wherewithal, the resources and experience and know-how to get it done, to get Judge Munson's order done within a month and a half. I have some great staff here at the Attorney General's office. All I did was give them guidance and leadership, and the work got done.
AG Barrett Anderson has been formally retired for 14 years, and while she will be stepping down from public office, she would like to engage the community in other ways, like through nonprofits or teaching at the local university. But as she prepares to pass the position to a new successor, she does have some words of advice to share.
I welcome and I encourage anyone who wants to run for this job. You need a lot of stamina. You need a lot of tenacity, strength. You need to deal with a lot of stress. But anyone who comes into this job who has not had the tenure of government experience, then the next Attorney General needs to rely heavily on the expertise of the attorneys in this office who are senior long-term government attorneys, and take their advice and take their counsel. Someone who has not had the experience in government service can still be a darn good attorney general, don't get me wrong, but I certainly encourage that person to rely on the expertise of the management staff here and the attorneys of the Attorney General's office.
Currently, no potential candidates have filed with the GEC before individuals have picked up candidate packets for the office. They are Jessica Barrett, Alberto Tolentino, Frank Gumatauto, and Levin Camacho. For this week's Decision Watch, I'm Kiani Mendiola.
Stay tuned next on Weekend Edition. We'll take a look at what stories were trending on social media. Keep it here.
There are more ways to experience KUAM News than any other source on Guam. Download the KUAM News app for your Apple or Android device for 24/7 news, sports, videos, weather, streaming with KUAM Radio, and important news alerts. And stay connected at home with Guam's first app for Apple TV. All available now from the App Store.
A simple handshake. That's all Jake Calvo needed when he started his company. Today, 80 years later, we like to say thank you to all of you who have taken our hand in trust. Thank you to the dreamers. Thank you to the realists. Thank you to the family-oriented. Thank you to the entrepreneurial. Thank you to those climbing the corporate ladder. And to the ones starting a new life together. Thank you to the traditionalists and the edgy, to the young at heart and the old souls. Thank you to the daring, to the protective, to the practical. Thank you to the hopeful. To all of you from all of us, our deepest, happiest, and infinite thanks.
80 years here for you. 80 years thanks to you. Calvo's Insurance, a legacy of trust.
If you get nervous about having dental treatment, you're not alone. An estimated 35 million adults experience anxiety or nervousness at the simple thought of visiting the dentist. As your dentist, I strive to make your visit as painless or pain-free as possible. And I frequently tell my patients that in the 21st century, if we can give you medicines to put your tooth asleep or medicines to take an infection or toothache away, we can surely give you something to help relax you and take all fear away. No one ought to sit in a dental chair thinking of bad childhood memories or fearing injections. If you're a dental coward, but you really do want your teeth fixed, don't wait until the pain is killing you. Come in, tell us your fears, and set up an appointment. We have convinced many that dental treatment doesn't need to be scary anymore. For your helpful dental minute, I'm Dr. Kenny Bourgeois, Paradise Smiles. You shall never know all the good a simple smile can do.
There are more ways to experience Guam via KUAM News, giving you what you want, when you want, and how you want it. From smart devices, Alexa, what's in the news?
Here's your flash briefing.
Over the web, on mobile, on streaming platforms, with immersive, interactive formats, and via social media where it's more than just content, it's conversation. More ways to keep you informed and entertained whenever you want it, wherever you are, on whatever device you're using.
Hoffman, and welcome back to Weekend Edition. Now time to check in with Asha Robles for this week's Trend Spotting.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Trend Spotting. Here's what caught your eye on social media this week.
~21-year-old Jay Nettidog, an in-house resident of an adult home at Sanctuary Incorporated, has been arrested for sexual assault. He is charged with third and fourth degree criminal sexual conduct. GPD investigation found three victims were sexually assaulted by Nettidog on separate occasions while at Sanctuary. According to Executive Director Therese Areola, Nettidog was in an adult transition shelter that is separate from the shelter for abused children. Though they were aware of his prior arrests, he met all the criteria. Requirements included homelessness, which Nettidog was, and a massive background check in regards to sexual assault and a police check clearance for child abuse and child assault, which he cleared, according to Areola. She says Nettidog's stay at Sanctuary's Young Adult Transition Shelter was immediately terminated and assures that this type of conduct is taken seriously, especially since Sanctuary works to be a safe space for children of abuse. One of our online viewers responded, "What is up with all the sexual assault and rape crimes here on Guam? The criminal justice system needs to reevaluate the sentencings of first-time and repeated offenders. Sexual assault leads to rape. I vote that sexual assault first-time offenders should serve a minimum of 10 years, second time a minimum of 15 years, and third time a minimum of 20 years. Sure, it sounds extreme, but our island is safer with these scumbags behind bars." Two men are accused of trying to steal more than $500 worth of oxen palm corned beef. Jesse Santos and Alan James Tovis are each charged with robbery, child abuse, and retail theft. Documents state one suspect started running out of Vinny's Mart in Barricado with three cases of corned beef in hand. An innocent bystander tried to stop them until seeing what appeared to be a handgun on the passenger seat of the getaway car. Police caught up with the suspects and chased after them. They eventually got out of the car after crashing in Dedido, where they took off on foot. That's when police say Santos was located and started yelling, "Okay, I give up." Tovis, along with two miners who were also inside the car, were found in a jungle area nearby. Rita Cruz states, "You're both an embarrassment to the Chamorro people. Time a malao." And Carlos Javier responded to her comment, "Right? You should be stealing spam and not corned beef. You're Chamorro, not Jewish." A big congratulations to all of the students who graduated from the University of Guam this past Sunday. All those years of late-night studying definitely paid off. UOG President Dr. Robert Underwood praised the hardworking students and gave his final commencement speech. "As I step away from this podium and no longer wear this robe or be weighed down by this heavy metal, the symbol of the university, I know that the university is in great hands," he stated. Here are some of the comments on our Instagram. Congrats to the Notre Dame Royals for winning this year's IIAG Girls High School Soccer Championship 4-0 over the GW Geckos. Cheyenne Roberto scored the first goal of the match, followed by a hat trick from Brianne Leon Guerrero. This is ND's third straight championship title. Congrats, girls. Here's what some of our Instagram users had to say.
Thanks for joining us. Catch us next week for more Trend Spotting.
Thanks, Asha. Stick around for more Weekend Edition after the break.
It's a celebration at Cars Plus and Mighty. And during our Jeep Celebration event, you'll save thousands on every new Jeep in stock. Like a new 2018 Compass. Save up to $3,750. Or save up to $4,000 on a new 2018 Cherokee. How about a new Renegade? Save up to $6,000. Plus, buy today and receive a Cars Plus value card where you get 21 cents off per gallon at all Shell stations. Hurry in for our Jeep Celebration event. Going on now at Cars Plus and Mighty. Cars Plus, driven by you.
Manukai Athletic Club and Manholden Swim Club present Guam Cocos Crossing 2018 on Sunday, May 27th. Experience the excitement of an ocean swim in the beautiful waters of Cocos Lagoon. Open to swimmers age 9 and up. Choose from three options, a 3K race, 5K race, and 10K race. Register online at guamcocoscrossing.com by Wednesday, May 23rd. Supported by these fine sponsors.
In this divided world, there are still things that unite us. Great music, thrilling games, and the love for that perfect burger. Ruby Tuesday Guam, for the love of burgers menu. For a limited time, get an amazing burger for just $11.99. Lunchtime at Ruby Tuesday Guam.
Have a day, everybody, and welcome back. Summer is now here, which means a lot of things. People are going out, but also sometimes kids actually stay in, whether it means that they're off for the summer and their parents trust them to stay home. A variety of reasons and everything. Sergeant Paul Tapao with the Guam Crime Stoppers program is here, and we are going to talk about, Paul, how we can make sure that parents know that their kids are okay and how they can make sure that they're not getting into trouble.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, summer is here. We're starting to see the ease in traffic and stuff. And one of the things that we were discussing is, you know, when is it prudent for a child to be able to stay home? And really the answer is you as a parent, if you leave a 6 or 8 year old by himself, you know, being that they can fend for themselves, then you risk the liabilities and anything that can happen to you. But we know we as the parents to make better judgment when you're going to actually leave your kids unsupervised by an adult or a prudent person.
Yeah. Legally speaking, is there any age that parents are able to leave their kids, you know, unattended, unsupervised? Or
you know, there is that latchkey effect that people, you know, the parents have where, you know, they give their child as young as 6 and 8 years old, the keys to their home, and I grew up that way. Mm-hmm. You know, it really does fall into responsibility and, of course, the supervision. If you feel that your child, I always believe that, you know, if you're old enough to drive and get a driver's license at 16, you're prudent enough to make reasonable and responsible choices. Mm-hmm. You're able to stay home by yourself, and, you know, that there is prudent, is a prudent age where parents can actually rely on their kids is to stay home and be self-independent while they're away at work. And, you know, if they're going to be in charge of supervising their younger siblings, then, you know, you're going to have to develop a system that works cohesively with what you want and your expectation as a parent.
That's a big responsibility mm-hmm. for parents to trust their kid with that, because not only is, okay, you know, you're supposed to fend for yourself, you're also trusting the kid to look after a house, which, you know, there's 1,000 different things that could go wrong with that.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, it really does come down with the parenting and the parenting skills and what's taught to the child about what they can do and, you know, leaving them with reliable contact numbers, who to call in the event of emergency and, you know, of course, not opening the doors up to strangers. But really, it's the parents have to make that hard decision of understanding when a child is prudent enough to stay home by themselves. You may have some parents who feel that a 6 or an 8 year old is, they can stay home by themselves, but really they do need adult supervision because of the fact of, you know, things that can happen. But mm-hmm. I have a firm, you know, I stand by the belief that if you're 16 and you can obtain a driver's license and be responsible enough to drive on our roadways, then you're prudent enough to stay home and be self-independent while your parents are away.
Okay, that's from the parent's standpoint, mm-hmm. but now from the young person's perspective, if I'm staying home, either because, you know, like it's summer and I'm just like taking the time off, my parents are at work, and something goes wrong, I may be, you know, playing with a ball and the ball goes underneath, you know, mm-hmm. a counter and I wind up like hitting a mouse trap I didn't know that my dad set, which actually happened to me. I may get hurt, I may be scared, like something weird's happening. What should I do? Should I call 911? Should I call my dad? Should I call, you know, my neighbor? What am I supposed to do if I'm a young person?
You should have a list of call list of who to call in an event of emergency. We set that up to at our house.
And in a certain order.
Mm-hmm. We have call lists where we have my, you know, the parents' phone numbers, your mom, dad, immediate relatives that are surrounding the area, and of course emergency calls such as 911. Teach your kids how to use 911. Know your address. You know, a lot of these kids, some of the kids in high school, they don't even know their address. It's important that you teach them that, because in the event of emergency where you do have to call, 911. They need to give an exact location as to your, where your home is at. So teach them how to use a call system and keep a call system in play in the event of an emergency such as that arises and stuff.
Okay, and then just for you young people, just so you understand, the Sarge is here. And if you call 911, the dispatch will determine whether you need the fire department or the police department.
Yes.
So just call 911, that's
just
all you need.
Just call 911 and they'll dispatch or disseminate the information accordingly. And if it requires where law enforcement is needed, they'll dispatch our law enforcement or our emergency responders such as our firefighters.
All right, and that's why you guys are here to get our back. Well, how can we help you now with the crime of the week?
Well, this week we want to report about a robbery that happened down in Agate, and this occurred on May 18th. And we're going to reach out to our southern villagers down in Agate. If they had any information, this happened around 11 o'clock in the morning, so please give us a call at 477-HELP.
All right, here's what you need to know.
The Guam Police Department is currently investigating a robbery that occurred on Friday, May 18, at the Agate A Mart in Agate. The police reports indicate that around 11 in the morning, an unknown male entered the store brandishing a pocket knife and demanded money from the cashier, as the suspect grabbed the cashier and led her to the register. Fearful for her safety, the cashier complied and handed the cash from within the register. The male suspect then leads the victim towards the store's main entrance, where the suspect was seen fleeing in an older model blue sedan. The suspect was only described as being local with a medium build, with long black hair that was tied in a ponytail. He was last seen wearing a white t-shirt and blue jeans. Now the Guam Crime Stoppers is asking the help from the community relative to this robbery. If anyone has any information about this crime or any other crime, you can call our 24-hour hotline at 477-HELP. That's 4357. Or submit a tip online at guam.crimestoppersweb.com. All calls will remain completely confidential, and a cash reward of up to $1,000 could be paid if the information provided leads to an arrest and a grand jury indictment. Your call does make a difference.
All right, Paul, we got to go. But next week, I was hoping we can talk about the very often misunderstood curfew law that exists on Guam.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll share that with the community. And, you know, when we do our town hall meetings, this is always a concern that comes up. What's curfew? How do we help? You know, what can we do as parents to make sure that our kids are in compliance with the law?
All right, we'll tackle that next time. We'll see you then.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
All right, we'll see you after the break.
Our mighty, mighty SUV Mega Sale is going on now at Cars Plus, and you're going to save big. With cash back on every purchase, get to Cars Plus and shop our great selection of Hyundai Santa Fe's, Tucson's, and the all-new Kona, Guam's most affordable SUV. Or our full line of Jeeps, like a new Jeep Renegade, save $6,000. Or a new Jeep Cherokee, save $4,500 with rates as low as 1.99% APR for qualified buyers. It's Cars Plus, mighty, mighty SUV Mega Sale. Cars Plus, driven by you.
In this divided world, there are still things that unite us. Great music, thrilling games, and the love for that perfect burger. Ruby Tuesday Guam, for the love of burgers menu. For a limited time, get an amazing burger for just $11.99. Lunchtime at Ruby Tuesday Guam.
Beat the increase at Triple J. Buy now before the sales tax starts. Zero down, 1.9% financing, and easy trade-in. Now is the time to buy. Get into a 2018 Mazda CX-5 at our lowest price yet, only $19,995. Or our big boy truck, the Ford F-150, starting at $298 per paycheck. Or the North American Car of the Year, the 2018 Honda Accord, at only $206 per paycheck. Beat the increase and buy now at Triple J. Visit us online at triplejguam.com and get pre-approved instantly. Trade-ins welcome. Some conditions apply. Triple J Auto Group, customers first.
And before we close out the news tonight, here's our latest round of birthday shout-outs from the Cold Stone Creamery Birthday Club.
Happy birthday, Michaela Rios. Also celebrating today, happy birthday, William O'Brien Rios.
Happy 14th birthday to Benjamin Lopez. Love, Mom, and the family. And last but not least, happy 9th birthday, Leona Joe Cepeda. Love, the family.
Remember, you can be part of the Cold Stone Creamery Birthday Club by logging on to KUAM.com. That's all the time we have here. From the news desk, I'm Crystal Paco. Good night.
Closed captioning is brought to you by IT&E.
Half a day. I'm Peter Duane.